Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Teaching Learning with Poornima once again. And today we will learn about the chapter Long Walk to Freedom, written by Nelson Mandela. Before we begin, let me tell you that the chapter Long Walk to Freedom is taken from autobiography of Nelson Mandela with the same name. Name of his autobiography is also Long Walk to Freedom, and the chapter's name is kept same. It was first published in 1994. In his book, he describes his upbringing as a child, how he was brought up, his early life in South Africa, his education, and his political life. Life as a political leader after joining African National Congress. It also shares his journey as a freedom fighter, what all he did as a freedom fighter, till the time he became the president of South Africa. It describes his struggle against apartheid and his role as the president of South Africa. It also shares his maiden speech, that is his first speech after becoming the president. Since it is the life story of Nelson Mandela, it is directly related to the history of South Africa. It's not a fiction. It's not an imaginary story. So let me tell you some important historical facts related to the chapter to help you understand it better. In South Africa, a political system named apartheid was formed in early 20th century. In the beginning of 20th century, first 15 or 20 years, a political system was formed. Actually, it was forced by the British government of South Africa that time. And according to this system, people on the basis of their race or color of skin were discriminated. The people who had dark skin were discriminated and they were treated brutally. It was one of the most brutal practices in which black people or the people of dark skin were deprived of their social and political rights. They didn't have any rights. They were not free to go anywhere they want. They were not free to join certain schools or colleges. They were not free to study certain courses. They were not free to do certain jobs. They were kept as slaves. Even sometimes they were traded as slaves. And they were beaten to death also. So Nelson Mandela fought against it. For that, he spent 27 years in prison. He was imprisoned for his struggle against apartheid. But eventually his efforts were awarded, they were appreciated, South Africa became free, and he became the first president of South Africa in 1994. With the detailed summary so that all the important points of the chapter are clear to you, the chapter begins with a description of inaugural ceremony of formation of fairly elected government, which was democratic and non-racial, creating an image of rainbow. In the beginning of the chapter, there's the description of inaugural ceremony, the first ceremony when the government was being formed. Nelson Mandela was taking oath as the president, and it looked like a rainbow because all the people of all the races, all the communities, all the castes, all the religion, and all the colors of skin were the part of this ceremony. They were present there. And all these people together took part in forming this government. That is why the variety of the people is referred to as rainbow. The ceremony took place on 10th May 1994, an autumn day in Union Buildings Amphitheater in Pretoria. This 10th May is very significant as it was an autumn day in South Africa. That time it was autumn season in South Africa. And what is the significance of autumn season? During this season, trees shed their old yellow leaves, and in their place, green, fresh, beautiful leaves come, new leaves come. So it is the significance of arrival of new order, which is fresh, discarding the old order. It means old dominating British government has gone and new fairly elected democratic government has come. The world leaders from 140 nations embraced this victory for justice, peace, and human dignity. This government was the victory for peace, justice, and human dignity. And political leaders, dignitaries from 140 nations became the part of this celebration. They rejoiced. They celebrated. In his speech, Mandela talks about political emancipation, that is political freedom. Political freedom means people are free to choose their government. That has been achieved. And he takes pledge. He takes oath. Wo kasam lete hain to liberate his people from poverty, deprivation, suffering and discrimination. Wo ye oath lete hain ki now on his people will not suffer from discrimination. Logon mein bhedbhav nahi hoga. They will not suffer from poverty and they will not suffer at the hand of other people. They will not be dominated, they will not be discriminated. South African jets formed a pattern over the building, leaving smoke trails of black, red, green, blue, and gold color of nation's flag, displaying precision and their loyalty to the government. When ceremony was taking place, Nelson Mandela was giving his speech, South African jets flew over the building, union buildings, and they made a pattern, a design unhone banaya, releasing the smoke of black, red, green, and blue, and gold color, which is there in South Africa's flag. And they displayed, they showed their precision, their skill, as well as they displayed their loyalty to the government, their respect towards South African flag. Armies and police, all the officers of armies saluted him instead of arresting him. If it had been British government, they would have arrested Nelson Mandela for being there. But now they are saluting him because they are saluting the government. Two national anthems were sung, the white singing African anthem and the black singing English anthem. Though both did not know the lyrics. Now this is the sign of Nelson Mandela's character, beautiful personality. He wanted to teach his people not to hate anyone. The Britishers have left, but he is teaching his people to respect their national anthem. That is why the white people are singing old African anthem. जो ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट के पहले अफ्रीका का जो एंथम था वाइट पीपल आर सिंगिंग दैट एंथम एंड ब्लैक पीपल आर सिंगिंग द एंथम व्हिच वाज डिसाइडेड बाय ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट दैट वाज इंग्लिश एंथम एंड बोथ आर सिंगिंग ईच अदर्स एंथम टू रिस्पेक्ट ईच अदर्स नेशनैलिटी सेंटीमेंट्स एंड इमोशंस दो बोथ डिड नॉट नो द लिरिक्स दोनों को वर्ड्स नहीं मालूम उनके मीनिंग नहीं मालूम एंड लेटर ऑन Both these anthems were incorporated and a new hybrid mixed anthem was made, which is accepted as the national anthem of Africa, South Africa, even now. He recalls that in the first decade of the 20th century, first 10 years of 20th century, 1900 to 1910, white supremacy erected white government, British government, made the system of racial domination. Apartheid. In this system, one race was being dominated. It was one of the most inhumane societies because inhuman treatment was done to the black people who were treated unfairly and brutally. Sometimes they were also beaten to death. They were not given any rights. And now it is replaced by a system. In its place, a new fair system has come, democratic government has come that recognizes the rights and freedom of all the people. It gives freedom and rights to all the people. Whatever race they are, whatever color of skin they have, and whatever religion they profess. He expressed his deep gratitude saying that he is the sum of all the freedom fighters and martyrs who couldn't make it to see this historic day. He expresses his gratitude to the freedom fighters and martyrs who have sacrificed their life in the struggle, who are not alive now to enjoy the happiness, to feel the happiness of this day, their victory. That is why he thinks that he is sum total of all those people. He feels himself as the representative of all the people, because he has been the part of their struggle. He had experienced what they have suffered, and that is why he can also experience the same joy what they would have felt if they had been alive. अगर आज वो जिंदा होते तो कितने खुश होते ये नेल्सन मंडेला महसूस कर सकते हैं. दैट इज वाई ही थिंक्स हिमसेल्फ एज द सम टोटल ऑफ ऑल द पीपल. ही फील्स दैट ही स्टैंडिंग एज अ पार्ट ऑफ दोज पीपल. ही प्राउडली रिमेंबर्स ओलिवर तांबू, वॉल्टर सिसुलू, यूसुफ दादू, ब्रैम फिशर एंड अदर फ्रीडम फाइटर्स, हाईलाइटिंग, स्ट्रेसिंग, सेइंग दैट इट रिक्वायर्स सच डेप्थ्स ऑफ ऑपरेशन. Oppression means domination, torture, atyachar, to create such heights of character. If there are depths of oppression, agar bahut zyada torture hota hai, we have heights of character. The character of the person is heightened, it becomes great. Jitna atyachar, jitni mushkil insaan samna karta hai, uska character utna hi uncha banta hai. क्योंकि आग में तपने के बाद सोना बनता है. मंडेला डिफाइंस करेज इज नॉट बीइंग द एब्सेंस ऑफ फियर बट द ट्रायंफ ओवर इट. बीइंग करेजियस डज नॉट मीन टू बी फियरलेस बट टू ओवरकम फियर. ही सेज दैट करेज डज नॉट मीन नॉट हैविंग फियर बट वन शुड विन हिज फियर. करेज इज द विक्ट्री ओवर योर फियर. Courageous person is not the one who does not have fear. Fear is a natural sentiment. One has to have fear. But courageous person can win his fear. Saasi vyakti wo hai jo apne dar ko jeet leta hai. He believes that if people can learn to hate, they can be taught to love. Because love comes more naturally to humans. British people have taught his people to hate one particular community. And he thinks that he can teach his people to love everyone. Because love is a natural sentiment. People are born with love. This society teaches us to hate. So we can definitely teach the people to love each other, one another. Once he saw a glimmer of humanity in a god and affirms his belief that flame of man's goodness can be hidden but never extinguished. Once during imprisonment, a guard did an act of kindness to him. और इसने उनके विश्वास को पक्का किया कि flame of man's goodness is never extinguished. इंसान के अंदर मानवता की जो ज्वाला है वो कभी बुझती नहीं है. Because goodness is intact with a human being. We are born with goodness. Our conscience tells us to do good always. The concept of freedom changed in various stages of his life. For him, the meaning of freedom changed in every stage of his life. He as a child wished to have freedom to play, to roam wherever he desires. जब वो बच्चे थे तो हर जगह खेलना, दौड़ना, भागना पसंद करते थे, and that was the meaning of freedom for him. As a youth, he wished to study and work according to his potential and passion and have freedom of marrying and living a lawful life. When he grew young, he wanted to study according to his potential and work according to his passion, as well as to marry the girl he wants and to have a family and live in a lawful life. That was meaning of freedom for him when he grew young. Later he realized that the idea of freedom was an illusion for him and the people of his race. When he grew adult, he understood that freedom is an illusion, a lie, for him and people of his race, the people of dark skin. And then he decided to fight for freedom, to live a life of dignity. Ek samman bhari zindagi jeene ka adhikar. Now this was the new meaning for him when he grew adult. He also mentioned twin obligations that every man has to fulfill towards his family and friends, and towards his society and nation. According to him, there are twofold duties for everyone to perform, to fulfill. First duty is towards our family, children, parents, wife, husband, relatives, and friends. And second duty is towards the society and nation, apne desh aur samaj ke logon ke liye. But he realized that he is not free to fulfill his second obligation. Apne logon ke liye kuch bhi karne ki unko azadi nahi hai. Then he joined the African National Congress to fight for freedom to enjoy equal rights and live a life of dignity. Ab unka zindagi ka maksad jo hai, समान अधिकार अपने लोगों के लिए और एक सम्मान भरी जिंदगी को हासिल करना बन गया था. अकॉर्डिंग टू हिम द ऑप्रेसर मस्ट बी लिबरेटेड जस्ट एज द ऑप्रेस्ड बिकॉज द ऑप्रेसर इज अ प्रिजनर ऑफ हिज हेट्रेड एंड प्रेजुडिस. टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस चिल्ड्रन मस्ट पे अटेंशन टू द मीनिंग ऑफ ऑप्रेसर एंड ऑप्रेस्ड. ऑप्रेसर इज द वन हु डोमिनेट्स, हु क्रशेस समबडीज सेंटीमेंट्स, हु सप्रेसेस समबडीज वॉइस, जो दूसरों की आवाज को दबाता है, जो दूसरों की भावनाओं को कुचलता है, अत्याचार करता है, वो ऑप्रेसर है. द ऑप्रेस्ड इज द वन हु फेसेस दिस टॉर्चर एंड डोमिनेशन. जो इस अत्याचार को सहन करता है वो ऑप्रेस्ड है. ऑप्रेस्ड इज नॉट फ्री बिकॉज हिज राइट्स आर नॉट देयर. द ऑप्रेसर इज ऑल्सो नॉट फ्री बिकॉज ही इज द प्रिजनर ऑफ हिज हेट्रेड एंड प्रेजुडिस. ही इज नॉट फ्री टू डू वॉट ही थिंक्स राइट. He is only doing what his hatred and prejudice tell him. वो वही कर रहा है जो उसकी नफरत उससे करवा रही है. Both are robbed of their humanity alike. Both are away from their humanity because they are not living the life of a true human being. They cannot enjoy human sentiments. They don't have human values. This lesson gives us an insight about how Mandela's high principles and noble thoughts helped him develop a society in which there is no discrimination. Mandela ke khoobsurat vichar aur unche aadarsh unko ek aisi society banane mein help karte hain jahan pe kisi mein bhedbhav nahi hai and all can enjoy their rights and live a life of dignity, jo ek samman bhari zindagi jeene ke liye logon ko azadi deta hai. His life story is an inspiration to all the strugglers, the ones who are struggling for some cause, and young aspirants, young people who have some dream to chase. His story motivates them not to give up ever. Mandela suffered for almost 30 years. He was imprisoned for almost 30 years, but he did not give up. At the end, he became victorious. So the same lesson young people can learn from his life. The style of the chapter is narrative because all the events and his experience are narrated by Mandela himself. The language is figurative. Expressions are beautiful and beautiful figures of speech such as metaphor and symbolism are used and his words are inspiring. His words can inspire the people to do good. As I have told you that the language of the chapter is figurative and diction is high. So let me tell you some difficult terms and expressions from the chapter. Extraordinary human disaster refers to mass casualties. Deaths in large number, brutal treatment, torture and oppression by the whites, white government, and martyrdom and sufferings of dark-skinned people, black people of South Africa in the course of freedom struggle due to the system of apartheid. अपार्थाइड का विरोध करते हुए बहुत सारे ब्लैक पीपल ने अपनी जान दी. दे सफर्ड, दे वर ट्रीटेड ब्रूटली. सो ऑल दिस वॉज टर्म्ड एज ह्यूमन डिजास्टर, ह्यूमन डिस्ट्रक्शन. एक्स्ट्रॉर्डिनरी मीन्स एट अ लार्ज स्केल, इन लार्ज नंबर. ग्लोरियस ह्यूमन अचीवमेंट, इट मीन्स द विक्ट्री ऑफ जस्टिस, इक्वलिटी एंड ह्यूमैनिटी over inhuman and brutal practice of apartheid. This glorious human achievement was actually the formation of democratic government, which was the victory of justice. Depths of oppression create heights of character. I have already told you the meaning of oppression. Here it means depths, degrees, highest degrees of oppression, suppression, domination, torture and sufferings, they test a man's character. जितना ज्यादा अत्याचार होता है उतना इंसान के कैरेक्टर की पहचान होती है, परीक्षा होती है. The freedom fighters faced brutal and inhuman treatment done by the English rulers and did not give up or surrendered. They faced brutal treatment, but they did not give up. उन्होंने हार नहीं मानी. On the contrary, this operation enhanced their power of tolerance. इसने उनकी सहन शक्ति को बढ़ा दिया. While continuing the struggle for freedom, equality and justice. And they continued their struggle for freedom, equality and justice. And that is why they became great characters. और इतनी मुश्किलों को सहने के बाद उनके कैरेक्टर में इतनी स्ट्रेंथ आई कि वो एक महान व्यक्तित्व बन गए. A twilight existence of secrecy and rebellion. This phrase means the life of a freedom fighter who was taken away from his family, जिसको उसके परिवार से दूर कर दिया गया, and society, और imprisoned या जेल में डाल दिया गया, if he had tried to raise his voice against apartheid and fight for their rights, for freedom, equality and justice. अगर उन्होंने अपने अधिकारों के लिए लड़ाई करने के लिए सोचा है, then they were imprisoned. Such person was labeled as a rebel, और उसको विद्रोही के रूप में कहा जाता था, and they had to live in a secret corner of some prison. उन्हें किसी अंधेरे कोने में, किसी अंधेरी कोठरी में डाल दिया जाता था, and that was life of secrecy and rebellion. Metaphorically, such life is compared to twilight, because twilight is the dark part of that day after which there is sunrise. दिन का वो समय जब अंधेरा होता है लेकिन उसके बाद उजाला हो जाता है. After that twilight we have dawn. And same way, this life of secrecy, this life of imprisonment and sufferings actually saw the dawn of freedom after some time. The oppressed and the oppressor are robbed of their humanity alike. This I have explained to you at the time of summary as well. This conveys that the person who suffers or faces torture is not allowed to live a life of dignity, like a human being. जो oppressed है, जो torture face कर रहा है, उसको एक इंसान के रूप में रहने का अधिकार नहीं है. Also the person who dominates और जो dominate करता है, crushes or tortures the other, is also away from human values and sentiments. वो भी ह्यूमन वैल्यूज और सेंटीमेंट से दूर है. इट मीन्स दैट द पर्सन हु ट्रीट्स अदर पर्सन ब्रूटली डज नॉट पजेस ह्यूमन वैल्यूज एंड सेंटीमेंट्स सच एज काइंडनेस, हेल्पफुलनेस, लव एंड फॉरगिवनेस. दिस हाउ ही इज ऑल्सो गोइंग फार अवे फ्रॉम ह्यूमैनिटी. सो बोथ आर अवे फ्रॉम ह्यूमन वैल्यूज एंड ह्यूमन सेंटीमेंट्स एंड द अदर पर्सन इज नॉट हैविंग राइट टू लिव लाइक अ ह्यूमन बीइंग. We quickly give you some question answers which you can pause the video and note down. If you have any doubt, you can write to me in the comment box. I hope the video is clear to you. If you have any doubt, that also you can write in comment. Thank you. Keep learning with me. Keep watching my channel. If you like my videos, subscribe my channel. Bye for now.